We are still in October, we're still learning about school, and this week we're kind of looking at it from a different perspective in that we're talking this week about homeschooling. And homeschooling is an option that has kind of skyrocketed in the last year since COVID happened. COVID did not happen a year ago, but it kind of feels like it was like 3 years ago. And so we as a family actually chose homeschooling. And so I've been really interested to learn more about it. And what I wanted to spend the time talking about today is deschooling. So when we transitioned from, we went from public school in person, so public school, virtual school, to homeschooling. And I, of course, was trying to, as I had done with virtual learning, I had accommodated everything. Like, we weren't doing everything that got sent home. We were doing what we could and we were sending it in for grades. But when it came to homeschooling, the first instinct is to try to recreate what happens in the classroom. And I knew that would not be successful. And a big benefit to homeschooling is that you don't have to do what happens in the classroom. But I think we as parents have this bias that says, if I don't do what happened in the classroom, then my child won't succeed, that they won't be able to keep up with their peers. And like, maybe that's fine. Like, maybe it's okay if we're not like on grade level, as long as our kid is actually learning what they're learning. One thing that I noticed is as I was reviewing stuff, there were things that were at a much lower grade level than what my kids were at. That they had not mastered. And I think it's because the school just like kind of breezed by it and expected you picked it up and then they didn't. And so now we're reviewing like super basic things, but we like it, we're having fun, we're enjoying ourselves. We started out with half an hour two times a day. And then we've increased to several hours in a stretch and we're doing fine with that. But that took us about 6 months. We schooled all summer. So the topic of deschooling goes along with this. You may have heard of unschooling, which is different. Deschooling is the process of almost detoxing your child from a public school environment. Homeschooling is not public school. It's not designed to be public school. It shouldn't be public school. It should be basically your kid gets like a super IEP, right? Because you are providing their FAPE or their free and appropriate public education. So you ensure that they get everything that they need to learn. But when you get pushback from a child, right, when you start homeschooling, it's probably because they are used to being in a public school environment where they feel dumb all day long. So if that's their situation and their relationship with school, how do you change how you're teaching them in order to help them feel more successful? How do you change their relationship with learning to not feel like I'm presenting you with information, you must respond and memorize accordingly, right? So some of the ways that that can be done is by making kind of like the world your classroom, which is the idea behind unschooling. It's more of a child-led learning experience. But for the first few months, even if you decide unschooling is like not your good long-term plan, which for many kids on the spectrum, it does work really well. The first few months after you transition off of public school, unschooling may be your best friend. So the reason that that is important to understand is because when we transition a kid off of public school, our brain goes to, we must do this class, we must do this class, and we must do this class. But if our kid's relationship with learning is tainted, we don't have that opportunity. So we need to take a step back and we need to make the world our oyster. We make homeschooling sound fun by being like, oh my gosh, let's go on this field trip in the middle of the day, which we would have never been able to do if we weren't homeschooling. Let's play this board game because I know it's educational, but maybe they don't. And so we can learn something. Maybe they mention that they're really interested in eyeballs and we watch an hour-long YouTube video on eyeballs. These are the kinds of things that get them back in love with learning so that we don't have that hesitation every time it's time for school, right? We generate that curiosity that they had when they were young kids and we build it up again so that when we go to learn something through homeschooling, even if it's a more structured approach, then it's received positively. So don't feel like the second you leave public school, you have to like hunker down and get it done because you're gonna fall behind. Don't stress about that. Your first job is what? Connection, right? Your first job is connection. And if connection plus learning don't work well together, that's fine. Learning in that structured way, that's fine. You can work on connection primarily, even if you do nothing else. And then it would be nice to marry alongside some learning. And that learning may look like apps. It may look like board games. It may look like books they really love. It may look like crafts. It may look like field trips. It could look like all of that. But these are all ways that we can work with our kids to kind of generate that love of learning and that curiosity. And that's the big goal in life, right? That they learn because they love to learn. So let me know in the comments what you think about this idea, if you have done this yourself, if this is helpful, and thank you for joining me.